Welcome everyone to more open source Linux Hool Linux distribution live development here. Stuff we do on this channel with our famous T2 SDE system development environment. Actually, now with this Facebook renaming in Matter, actually would have been Matter Linux. Matter. Maybe we should have that. Ironically, fun fact before we start. I just recently realized that our company Exacode, in retrospect it would have been cooler just to have Xcode, and ironically Exacode predates Apple's Xcode development environment. Back in that day, that was Project Builder, so long in that field. So when we at that time did not copy Xcode, but yeah, a little bit of a missed opportunity similar to. But then again, the crazy thing is big mega corporations naming, renaming their stuff like Matter or Apple, and we could not get, as a small little German company, even in 2006 already, we could neither ExactScan nor Exacode registered as text mark, word mark, or what that is in English. Because the German, also, yeah, you have an English name and then the German market official there, a trademark official, people there is like, yeah, rejected, because it's only a combination of English words. It's like, yeah, and Apple and Microsoft and Facebook, and it's like, yeah, so much to big business. And yeah, even 2006, I think some years ago, as far as I remember, there was, also by the way, why is this still building when this already failed? Because that was killed already, not sure why is this still doing something strange and stuff. There was a reform of this markets trademark stuff just some years, like in 2006, some 3, 4, 5 years before that. So we just missed by European standards registering more normal English terms like Exacode and Exactscan as trademark. It's so silly. It's a recurring theme of small business losing everywhere and big business just doing whatever they want, including massive tax evasion and stuff. But anyway, so nearly everything just freaking builds TM, except small little things. It's like small little things, Firefox on ARM for some strange reason, or some not strange, for some Rust reason. As you see, some Rust of Mach build getting killed, not also there Rust there. Anyway, I guess we just don't ship Firefox for ARM for now. We still have it for ARM64. I more wonder, I guess, if we are honest with ourselves, it doesn't make, or it's not the most important to like release T2 today. We could just ship it now, more or less anyway. Build time, by the way, building 25 build variants probably in like overnight. The builds aborted and stopped like at 4 o'clock in the morning for some random reasons, which like also this straight out directories. So yeah, build time pretty amazing on this not epic and nearly thread ripping Ryzen 1550X that is relatively good. The only thing better would be in real epic or thread ripping and more memory, like not out of memory. And yeah, I guess if we're honest with ourselves, we could just release it now, but I guess it's better to just wait in a little bit, because next week should be Firefox 95 or so, and Linux kernel 5.15. So I guess it makes probably sense to wait one more week. I think that, yeah. But leave in the comments below. We can shortly live stream. So what we already do live stream. Some small things I've already, like, why we built this corrected. Awesome. Thank you very much. One thing I think I finally quirk aka YOLO, one thing that is a stray change directories, which is pretty annoying, because the build stops randomly like man pages or Linux kernel. What do we have here? CMake. All right, CMake. That is funny. So okay. OpenRisk. Nearly everything builds except like, but yeah, with 25 architectures and 300 plus minus packages, depending on minimal desktop or not, or Firefox Rust Cargo. A hell of a lot of stuff, just builds, and except the usual stuff, CMake, whatever dependencies. Also this was uselibc. I'm more interested in the other surrounding stuff there. So let's try to finally live shellcode here some more stuff. Where would be maybe build? So what I want to do since some time already, this is of course silly, we don't really, this is like shared files. This check is like a sanity check of our own that we have for 20 years in T2 and Rock Linux. And that's just because one package cannot, or two packages, multiple packages cannot install one file, sync, sendmail or bash or stuff. So each file should be unique. And that is a simple check for that. And this is basically directory. So what's happening is this make files most likely touch this directory. Probably they have makefile rules like that. If directory doesn't exist or something, then mkd or something, this is why we have that there. It's not only man pages, it's also Linux kernel with /temp for some annoying reason. And also vim. Basically it happens for all, like recreating temp. It's a little bit silly. It happens basically with everything that does mktemp based on the timestamp or makefile rules or other similar such stuff. Super annoying. And I think I usually it's a new thing, probably with new make or mkdir versions or something, or touch or something like that. I've basically two or three really super annoying things that mostly annoy me because we build most of the stuff here. It's of course a little bit annoying for you at home as well, especially if you don't understand what this is. The time has come after so many years that we finally somehow fix that. And I think I was thinking a little, should we like do something sophisticated or so? And I think we probably should disable remove this configurable. I think it should not be possible to disable this paranoia checker, by the way, because I saw some people like Puppy developers or Puppy Linux developers, which at times use T2 for small packages like this, disable that, and this should simply not be disabled. So maybe we should actually simply remove this if paranoia check this conditional thing there. And I think we simply restructure this code and check if it's a directory here. We could, the possibilities and as usual nearly endless, we could check in the flist wrapper if it's a directory or something, but beside costing performance, well, I don't want performance and not making the Linux kernel build like 5 seconds slower. Also, I don't want to, this like sandbox flist wrapper stuff is already C and complex enough. I think it makes the most sense with all the possibilities that are to somehow work around that, to do that here in the post-processing simply. Also, this is the least performance impact, right? If we do something in the flist wrapper, the performance impact could really be a percent or two, and adding that up over time, we rather want to optimize stuff, not make it slower again, because the faster the better, obviously. And also, that check then here, if we do that in post-processing, of like, is this shared file a directory, and then like, yeah, ignore it, like Debian does, for example. They also simply, I think Debian, for the most part, doesn't even have the concept of having directories in packages. I think like directories are usually not owned at all by packages in Debian, but at least the last time I checked, not sure if they have this for special directories, but anyway, so yeah, that certainly usually we don't have shared files. And if we have a handful of shared files, it's of course neglectable performance impact of checking whether it's a directory, whether to error out or not. So let's quickly do that in a second. What do we have here? We have here, why? All right, we have an VI, so maybe we use, whatever. Let's see, comments. comment there from some ex-org server commenting, "Oh, we could drop Firefox for good, certainly it's still needed." Well, I mean, Firefox, I don't understand, like, maybe comment more. I don't hate Firefox as much. I made a couple of critical videos. I think Mozilla or could have done a way better job. But Firefox, for the most part, mostly works, and the code base is easier to build except Rust and Cargo than Chromium. So, and also the, yeah, I mean, Chromium is not that much better, right? So Chromium, the code base is even more convoluted and full with strange dependencies. And wondering how much mini SED different in terms of functionality compared to GNU SED. Well, it doesn't support most of the GNU extensions. Most of the POSIX conformance stuff probably should work. I've never like really tested that. I only know from the history books and Wikipedia and stuff that once upon a time this mini SED was the GNU SED, right? So in the 90s, that nowadays mini SED was the GNU SED, as far as I understood, until the GNU folks rewrote that. We could theoretically, but for science, we could actually try to make a T2 build with mini SED as system SED and see how much breaks. But it's not really that important for me. I rather rewrite that in some like saner Rust or Zig or whatever language. For me, it's, I maintain it, but this old 70s, 80s style C code, not the biggest, most important thing to maintain. Or add more. I wanted to, what did I want? All right, yesterday someone, was it NIM programming language, or I've actually not yet really taken a closer look to that. We probably could for now. Oh, data is ready. I started data earlier, slightly wondering that it runs so fast, but here we are. Need a little bit careful, but this is mostly GNOME and Valor. So yes, isn't it nice to have your personal data bot working for you? I'm actually soon, will put money where my mouth is, and because I always had collaboration, of course I would have hoped the channel would have grown more by now, but I always said I also do this to collaborate with more people and fund open source development. Maybe actually I put, starting with a little, because obviously only earning some hundreds of euro a month with this YouTube channel yet. But maybe I use this to, not that I should use it for myself, but maybe I start soon to give this back a little bit to the community, to the T2 community. Certainly not Linux Kernel, so, but they have enough money there, it's the Linux Foundation. But starting with like $5 or $10 for T2 issues, but not any, like not yet, that you file your own and then post a patch, but like patch bounties for like stuff filed by me or approved by me here, like more major stuff. Certainly $10 is not super much for stuff that might take some minutes or hour to work on, but nonetheless, maybe that is nice to fund students and other people in the world and stuff and engage and spread the word here. NIM, I think, yeah, a new issue. Like stuff like this. Not sure other stuff, maybe I also do this this myself, but in general, like, for example, Swift. All right, also then only when we finally, like, if the patch is totally unclean of YOLO together, then of course, not until it, like, if I have major complaints of this should not be done like this, and of course Linus Torvalds style, please this rediff and rebase and clean up some. Yeah, new programming languages. The more the merrier, right? Maybe already enough. But we might add our own, right? Add Swift language. Yeah, no, whatever, whatever. I think this is enough. Maybe it's easy to add. Maybe I try this later, but just as a reminder for people out there. Okay, this stuff is building. Maybe we commit bin utils of, as I did. Because like lib intil for UC, lib intil with UC. Bin utils later. So we have, I think this is fine. Needs, oh darn, did I had there? Oh no, this is fine. Should, oh yeah, okay, I just removed that. We will see, more build, more testing. Thinking about packaging Erlang though, seems pretty convoluted, I think you mean. Yeah, that is my recurring theme, right? If people wonder why I'm often so critical, and at times some people might complain negative, but it's like, yeah, 20 years of bugs, regressions, and convoluted dependencies. It's like, yeah, eventually that is how it is. So, shared files, let's see. Check for shared files. Read, I mean, so this is reading XArg, cut, by the way, do we still need this? Is this, this here, by the way, might only be because previously I'm with Linux so long, I remember a time when there was a command line argument, right, for monolithic C is difficult kernel structure. So there was only, not sure what the limit was, maybe 4K or 64K or something, or whatever. There was a limit of command line argument length. So in Rock Linux, 20 years, even 20 years ago, we sometimes hit this, right? Depending where you checked out the sources, the user source, so long as the user source stuff was, of course, and then the more packages we added. So some of this stuff, this, for example, might be workarounding this limit. This was changed long time ago, Linux command line length, maybe 3.0 of command line argument limit. I knew there were some typos here. So, all right, so 132K apparently, arg max of 1 or 2,000 characters probably should have been enough. Is it still, wait a second, is this still the limit, or is it now dynamically, shall I say limit usually something something? Anyway, whatever the limit is, it was increased long time ago, like three something, or here at least 2.6. What do they have here? Just a little bit of fun fact. Googling E too big for 2.6, what did they had there? Oh, 32K, oh, that could, yeah, so it was not something like 130,000. Now it's 4 GB apparently. No, whatever. Anyway, now it's big enough. Okay, now, and one argument must not, like one of them, of the many, 132K. It's like, yeah, that certainly should be enough for everyone. But this limit we hit sometimes. And so theoretically we could actually remove that. Now let's, I guess that is like splitting that with 120X arcs. Let's see, X arcs. No. Yeah. Max arcs, yeah. And not sure how many we have of those left. Maybe some. But at least in that case, we could actually, so that is, yeah, I guess nowadays we can just, if your operating system doesn't support it nowadays, then yeah, whatever. So this was XArcs N128. So actually, you know what? Also, additionally, we could, so this is also a little bit superfluous. I mean, not that, because it's two processors and like IPC piping that between two processors, we could also make next, like micro optimization, not that it would, if you build T2 on a Spark station with 40 megahertz. Because otherwise, we're not sure who wrote it. Like, although, okay, maybe this was probably XArc rated, right? Okay, so this is fair enough. And also, I think we don't need that here, do we? This should work naturally. So yeah, nowadays we can write it as simple as this. The other, like, echo XArcs cat. Also, we could directly have XArcs SED, right? But anyway, so much to shell scripting and old stuff. So this is of course just like micro optimization. Like we would really need that. What is that here? Grep SED XArcs R. Whatever. We don't need to change each currency of that stuff. Let's see if that still works. That was previously erroring out on shared main page directories. And that still works. And the last days I've done a number of such tiny cleanups, right? A little bit of, yeah, old style and this, and multiple TRs to one SED and so on. Just to make this a little bit more modern, more readable, more, yeah, so on. So, by the way, do we use this dummy? Probably not dummy. No, we don't use it. What I usually do is use underscore something or X or whatever. Dummy is a little bit, yeah. At least in Lua, I use underscore. Phone shared files with other package. Where's I, by the way? Ah, this is, how does that work here? Phone dubs in. Ah, this is just the header. This is just printing the header. Via read. Setting that. Okay, this is if we read something, so how does it work? We SED Z sort unique. So this is SED. What exactly does it do? Let's quickly, so let's go to alpha, because why not? That would be main pages SED substitute. Okay, it is substituting main pages to dot main page. Okay, we don't have, so this is dot, and then why does it even do that? Unique, oh, it's removing. So why is it, no, we have a fly in here, or a B or a, so much to opening the window, nature. Welcome everyone. This looks a little bit superfluous, to be honest. Sort, so this is sort by key two. This is a little bit silly. I also don't understand. Maybe had some historic development of it was written differently before. We could simply, instead of substituting it first and grepping other later. This is just removing that. So this is because I would say we could we not directly run sort of those? mean, I wouldn't say it's a performance optimization of substituting a couple of package names to dot and just grab dot. Would that be any? I don't think this has most. I would say the substitution is more expensive than... Watch me life hunting. Flying animals here in the office. Yeah, you want to YOLO something and rewrite the whole shell loop. Let's see if we directly can sort K2. I think that should work, not? Okay, two, so this... why do we even need to... unique. Okay, unique, what is unique? Delete... okay, so we need the sorting for the unique. For... unique does work on field. Ah, this is interesting. I think I never used unique with... I didn't even know that this supports a field, I think. The more you only print duplicate lines, one for each group. The truest field of avoid comparing the first n fields. Yep. I would say, or does it, does this dot? Ah, I think I understand why they do the, maybe Claire did. I think this is for sorting, so that to make sure other... Or would it? I wanted to say with sorting to make sure it's like not the first, but no, delete duplicates field. Interesting. Should we... Maybe we should test. I mean, I don't really need to rewrite this now. Just when I guru meditate about such stuff, then I sometimes like to clean that up just to avoid... Like, if I guru meditate now, then my thinking is it should maybe be not written. What we don't have? What do we have? Man pages in our kits also. We need that and sort grab what? Dear tree, man 2, 3, something. Okay, but that works in theory or not? Just like, why do we not get a grep? Oh, wait a second, do we have? CDF lists, grep L file. Okay, then it is grepping again, which packages, theoretically. Could this not be somehow done more elegant? Because we have that in the sorted data already, but anyway. Slightly, this is interesting that this works without semicolon. Apparently new line is enough. So, grep file, and so just why do we x package should be man page colon, what else did I, something is not yet working here, sed man pages, anyway, what was my thinking earlier, got a little bit distracted of understanding the shell code here, so my thinking was, do we need to substitute that? Let's Let's see if sort K2. And grep wanted to test that actually. Usually I like to pre-test that. So we read the file, so that is the file there. What do we, wait a second, this is not, this is grep this. Let's see if that still yields the same result. And then I will add the conditional. So what I actually wanted to do is adding a conditional to check. Oh, well, this somehow doesn't work so much to warp, warp, warp. Sort K2, unique, grep, so something if that doesn't work. Maybe there was a reason why someone had done it like that. But this is also add documentation to this, right? So this was like men2. We have here men2 and a file. No. Ah. Wait, why do we not have, somehow this is sort K2, unique. Ah, right, okay, because of the unique is not. Why does this not work anymore? There is men2. Why does this not sort K2? Oh, also this is wrong. This is why. Oh, this is very clever. Maybe I just compared again the wrong data. So we had that is empty, and then okay, so that is better and probably what we wanted, except this is now, oh wait a second, why? Okay, this does not, I see, check shared. What do we do here? Sort all files. Ah, okay. So okay, maybe this was indeed sorting. So that this is the first and grepping for, because now we have 00 deer tree. And we don't want, okay, so this apparently was indeed for a reason. I would think that with that sorting plus probably should come first, otherwise as I speculated some 10 minutes ago, so that alphabetical sorting is randomly, obviously not randomly, depending on what package and shared file combination, not guaranteed to be the first. So So SED, so that is that, and then grep one step four and one step back. Where do we have that? Yeah. So then let's do that. And grep for dot, was it like that, or escaped dot? That probably should be better and work then. Still tiny cleanup. Again, a little bit expensive cleanup, maybe this is the one not to touch. Running system. So SED, the stuff here on all those files. Sort. I'm slightly wondering, I thought I grabbed a couple of times for constructs like that and changed that already previously. Okay, there previously wasn't the space, not that it would matter too much, but so then. So this would be shared files. So for any of this shared files, do that. And I would say it is as easy as done. So while something done, let's SED. Commons, right? Package. Yeah, whatever. And here, if it's a directory, then it's like, yeah, we're not interested. So that would be root file. So that is not including a slash. If this is a directory, then continue, not interested. We could also set x for, I usually like to, especially this kind of stuff, test a little bit, obviously, because otherwise, alright, we didn't rebuild that because we previously had a typo in there, get text. Oops, I wasn't get, but it wasn't in pages. And then this should finally get rid of most of this super annoying and unnecessarily annoying. Random build errors like this, because obviously this, I should have done this years ago, but also if you think you have a better solution to that or code or whatever, leave in the comments below. So this should theoretically have tested two files, which are these two here, directory. So this is the root prefix here. So there, that appears to work as you see. And if this is not a directory, this should still. So yeah, I think this is simple, beautiful, not too intrusive, and I hope you learned something as usual from the shell scripting. Also, yeah, why nor shared directories. What did I want to say? Found local. What do we have here? SED. Here it is doing the same trick as in substituting that to only grep on this packages. Actually interesting trick. So yeah, that should certainly one other small step for hiding shared directories like other Linux distributions do, and micro optimizing this code here. So this is micro optimizing in not xargs and also SAD directly without cat, and still Improved scripts build package to not shared directories. Actually, we still have, we will somehow probably remove a couple of more because we still have slash temp, and that is a little bit a different case. You would think slash temp of Linux kernel and Vim somehow touching, recreating slash temp, because that error is different. This is not, unfortunately, another code path that is files out of, are we focused? Files out of top level directory. I guess it's focused if you ever wanted to see me, is that sure? So improved script build package to not error out on shared directories. Yay, another random build error gone. And yeah, build all. Actually, we have a couple of more build errors. I said nearly everything build RADM. Like exotic architectures we built the first time. Like x86, why is that failing? Exotic architectures. Ugh. Libintel DRM? What? Need to check that. But otherwise, yeah, okay, microblaze is something else, but I saw there's some Xorg server or Mesa. Some other Mesa. Yeah, also, actually, ironically, should fix our impact. Okay, this is, I thought this was a microblade, though. What is? Was this Vim? Okay, Vim is, we probably also want to change that a little bit. Why is this now? Vim is trying to build X with Xorg. That is of course not ideal, so this we just simply run all those builds. That should all in parallel, of course, because why not? Oh, okay, we actually rebuilt quite some bin utils because I just changed it from stage 1 to stage 2 for having used the libc and libintel there, as seen earlier. So yeah, just rebuilding bin utils a couple of times. So it will actually result in quite a high load because it is quite parallel, so that will be a load of 200 something soon. Hey. So, Intel Optane swap used, written up with 96 gigs of memory because obviously, yeah, increasingly professionalizing and even more overkilling. Obviously need a larger Intel Optane. This was just, I got this for like €9, a 16 gigabyte. Certainly small Optane, I just wanted to see how it works in practice. But Intel Optanes are really rare on eBay, especially cheap ones. What is this? Or somehow I have the feeling this new version of Alacrity is, I recently updated this just the other video, and now it has here some strange, yeah, new bug. So they wrote this in Rust, right? Because memory safety and bugs and stuff. Not only did Alacrity previously already crash a couple of times, But now I realize it has some. I think I never. I never had this, so this must be a new bug, unfortunately. This is so hilarious. Yeah, whatever. Okay, this is also. So, yeah, so load probably load 66 on the 32 thread Ryzen. Okay, man pages, why do we still, this is actually what I wanted to fix, why do we still, alright, this actually might be a real thing, alright, darn. Okay, so, but it's also a good test, testing, and more testing. This means our rewritten code still works. I just need to uninstall that for all builds because this file was already installed. I fixed the manpage package already to not install that file. But of course it was already built there. So that would be for, or better, for B in all of those, or maybe this, that do. So that would be mine. That root uninstall manpages and then we still have those log files, so yeah. So good that we accidentally tested that. Yeah, nobody commented yet. We could actually, should we ask a major audience? Also, maybe just for entertainment anyway. Nobody really commented on that. I think it makes sense to wait some days. For the basically like a week. Because after all this attention to detail, it's not that important to like rush it now. So people want Rust or P3. How many people have 72? Because this changed. I think previously this was. Oh no, this is actually. Actually, I think it changed quite a bit the last day. Was it? I think it was. Wasn't image 30%? And I think this changed to less image, less important, more Rust, and interesting. Oh, wait a second, did even more people come? Something of that sort. Although, of course, what I want to say, yeah, it's usual prints for some bizarre reason. This is what I wanted to say. I wanted to say, of course, the risk is with the new Linux kernel, new regressions, right? So it's like, yeah, you wait for Linux, wait another week for Linux kernel 5.15 and Fox, it's 95, right? Could also include that link to that video. Like good YouTuber promotion do. Yeah, amazing stuff, right? Copy and paste with... why did this even... Alright, because this is a bloody... this is so stupid. Oh man. Do we have paste and match style? This is so sad. Let's see, does it post properly with a proper link, or will it be... Maybe it did. Oh wait, this is the wrong... Yeah, it doesn't matter. Actually wanted... Why did the... why is this... Can we cross-compare the object? Wait a second, why is this... Ah, maybe... YouTube creator can't operate... YouTube web... stuff live on. By the way, I hear from the fans, this is actually some fans, an indicator whether stuff still works. Someone down voted that already. Okay, this is the right link, not sure what I clicked there. So, stuff is building. What is that? That is on MIP64. Right? That was previously aired out on Impact. Also, yeah, you probably want a recurring theme, GitHub sponsor, OnlyFans, GoFundMe, YouTube membership, or Patreon. Because I also need to finalize and polish the SGI Impact stuff, because, of course, I need to do. And what else do we have here? So this is main. So most builds failed on either main pages or Linux kernel. Linux kernel usually /temp. Probably it's building Linux kernel there. One bizarre thing is that AVR32 failed. Ironically, I thought we had done that, and now it fails really early with GCC. Not why? Why does this fail here? Why does it make, is it, I have like no, we have some architecture AVR32. Also, I think the load is so high that at times it feels already, no, the load is only free. The interactivity is starting to be a little of annoyance. Yeah, very little memory. It's just so, yeah, this is this temp stuff. We could maybe I special case that too, because I really don't have that much time. So yeah, we just delete some stuff behind the back, because I didn't want my machine to hard lock up again with no memory. So yeah, compiler need memory, and I need more memory. I think I finally YOLO that, because I can't see this random breakage anymore. So that, let's do the similar. Let's simply whitelist allow list /temp there. I only wonder, by the way, theoretically, allowed to publish root since Qt. Why do we not simply, anyway, f-list root, why do we not allow temp? F-list root pin root, why is temp not in there? Although, hey, Dr. Schubert tuned in, also, no YouTube complaints. Dr. Schubert, everything without always broken Firefox. Not entirely. Firefox builds for all supported platforms, like not Intanium, not MIP64, not 32-bit PopPC. So for like five or so, like x86, hopefully, -64, ARM64, PowerPC64. So usually for most it does build except ARM 32-bit, but yeah, also Intanium, I guess. Yeah, T2 builds for Intanium, but probably still pending some of your patches. Of needing Intanium patches to not only build but also work. The only thing, so top level, so this is F-list root, F-list for file list root. The only reason of not having temp in here would be that this is a sandbox. So if we have like source, like your source, user source, somewhere source, your checkout, new sandbox temp, I mean, we could have stuff in temp there, but we could differentiate between sandbox temp, where stuff should usually not be written, and the build system's temp. So check file creation, actually we have low root since create some proof or something top level directory OV. What? Yeah, no, OBS probably was also killed of a content total or whatever. So yeah, so much to live streaming from you. Not as overkill as you hoped. Yeah, quite some. It's probably the ARM thing that was going on there, Firefox ARM. Thankfully, yeah, there's also the difference, right? Previous video of not having a tempfs for each build and totally deadlocking. Previous video 2021, you can still deadlock your kernel with tempfs, because obviously state of IT. Temp. The sources here. Ironically, this was, by the way, a test for the last build. I had Firefox also disabled for ARM. I only tested whether it builds now. I actually had here probably still a comment of ARM Rust crashes of like, yeah, it's still a thing. So we have this Firefox currently only for the three platforms, and I think theoretically, I mean, theoretically, we could actually test that. But the last time it was crashing, though, unless we check if that was. I mean, we have some spare time. Theoretically, this should be fixed anyway. And once upon a time, Spark also worked. I think previously Spark 64, I even patched that a little bit. I think it came up, but the irony here is, some months ago I fixed it to build and start, and then just the next update broke it again to segmentation fault. We could test it though. Do we have this somewhat alphabetically sorted there? Spark. I mean, maybe we try it. And then anyway, yeah, I only removed this because shipping segmentation faulting binary is not the most amazing thing in this world, but it gives you some surrounding packages like GTK or something, and potentially at least covering the build and keeping it building. It's already better than not building. What did we do? All right, tempfs. I mean, maybe we just add this here. The only question is f-list root, where do we... I I think I'll just add this here because I just want my stuff freaking built. So most of that except Xorg, so let's, where is, alright, all the main pages, so this should be taken care of now. And there are quite some Linux, which is the Xorg, so Xorg server is something like Neos 2, of course, and that is, did I disable Mesa for, I'm not even sure if Xorg still does it. Oh, wait a second, I don't have, what is here with, did we even build Mesa for Neos 2? We built Mesa for Neos 2, interesting. Just built, so why does Xorg fail then? Did you mean, am I screening it? Why? What is here the first? Somehow, this is not entirely sure. All other architectures apparently built. Can we disable? Egg-shared memory fence. This is why. Okay, so Xorg breaks itself when you disable DRI. Egg-shared memory fence. Lib egg-shared memory fence. But we have, why do we not have that for, we only remove that for Spark, why? That was libx shared memory, but we built that, why does it, maybe undefined symbol to, let's try Neos 2, obviously don't even have the hardware, nobody ever will have this hardware, but so I think we are out of focus because lighting. Ach, come on, camera. That looks pretty out of focus. Come on, you can do it. We have it. Yeah, let's already change in there. This probably will fail. But yeah, certainly this small stuff of shared file directories and files and temps, like totally unnecessary. Should have done this for years. This is tiny. So the usual stuff, right? You're for 20 years, 99% done, and then all the usability killed with some random small little breakage like that. Small, annoying, and for end users, totally not understandable, obviously. So this was libx shared memory shared. Oh, wait a second, why is this in here? That probably explains a thing, but how does it get in there? Could escape that, but whatever. Is the libdrm fence of libatomic ops? That is why. Okay. I guess we don't have atomic ops for. Apparently. Let's double check that. Meteor generates a config for that to be in there, otherwise package was hard to remove due to architecture. So the fixed titanium now working on bachelor thesis too, so take some time. Yeah, no worries. Would be amazing if one day you find some. Oh, why did this not build? Lab atomic, do I have two? Two. Yeah, would be amazing if one day you find this time. Or actually, wait, oh, now it builds. Okay. Why? Okay, let's not over remove that stuff. Then let's see if that fixes XORG server. Theoretically, of course, the XORG server should be fixed and patched also to build without shared memory, fans, and libDRM stuff. Oops, underscore, of course, not press shift enough. Apparently that works now. So yeah, then shared files, temp, hopefully fixed. Let's test build that also. Like, for example, let's check with Mipser. What do we have in Mipser? Is it the kernel or? Yeah, let's check if that is. Oh no, this is. We killed this away. Fine. We could just build this, but I built this with parallel 4 because we just built so many of those. So let's raise it to 32 again and Mipsel to see if the Linux kernel. Okay, so this build now indeed. This we committed already. And let's maybe see if we have build errors for Vim. We have only one, so this one is this. Let's see, is that okay? We actually deleted that behind. But anyway, I will find sooner or later whether that works. So, otherwise, stuff building, NEOS 2. So, what else do we? So, most stuff actually done. So it's 25 architectures, including first time X32, and X86 is built twice, once for glibc and once for musl, for your small, minimal, more standard conformant C library there. And X32 with glibc just for the added performance, right, previous level. Makes no sense, in my opinion, to build X32 for improved performance, and then you have less performance due to musl libc. What do we have? The following packages have dependencies, which are this other stuff, build package. So temp. Let's wait shortly. We don't need to rush that now. And then I hopefully can finally focus on my microkernel. Two votes. Certainly need more for that. So yeah, then unfortunately it's not an October release anymore, but not that it would matter in any way, shape or form. What is it? NEOS 2 or so? It's no MIP64. Yeah, stuff beautiful building. Also not that, but source. Fix manpage shared files, done that, test potentially finish, and we certainly need to do that. That sometime later, cross compile cargo, done. Is it not amazing how we rip through those to-do items? So yeah, this is a little bit of looking up for that, that we actually we should really done do urgently, like soon. Also, I guess we rename that 11 already. And okay, this we actually really need to do also, because without that, quite some KDE packages don't build. Delete log message files, remove custom packages. So, what do we have there? Linux to a building. Yeah, the load is probably 40. Yeah, 32 plus 8 of two builds here and there. Yeah, two builds by four. Yeah, so really nice progress. The only other thing I actually could test is if our mini SED, if we echo. Actually, I had this on my to-do for today, but someone asked. So, range of matching 2 to 5. Group delete, no such command as. Ah, this is probably just this. Yeah, so this actually works. Let's maybe could also duplicate those lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That even works. And if we have substitute one to underscore. All works like intended in our mini SED. How boring, no bugs to fix. I slightly wonder how many range tests we have, which we should make. Oh, we actually have quite some range tests. There have been quite some bugs historically. Okay, this is 2. This is 8. Oh, this is B to D. Actually, this is kinda sorta. This is range 3. We have kinda sorta. Yeah, line. So this is exactly cool. We have even a test case for that. So we have also a silicon motion. What was with that thing? That is on NEOS 2. Might be silicon motion. That is actually what we have for silicon. Probably IO stuff. IO read write or. Usually it is off here in byte, of course. So silicon motion. Not going to patch that. Certainly nobody ever uses that on silicon motion anyway. Oh, this is actually, ironically, actually it has PowerPC. I mean, basically, what is even left here? Actually, let's revert that. Such few architectures working, we better. Maybe it's easy to patch, but who cares? Maybe they have already PowerPCs and whatever, but all builds of ADM logs silicon motion. Actually quite some we have here. Alpha, actually more than I expected. This is error for log we have. So x86 PowerPC, X and MIPS alpha. Yeah. Let's make this in positive list. And by the way, what was there? Was, yeah, ARM. Let's keep it there where we type. So that was MIPS, MIPS 64, PowerPC, PowerPC 64, x86. And so we don't need to constantly update this with everything else not building. Let's see, does it cover everything? Alpha. We forgot Alpha. Oh, Spark. We built this for Spark. Of course, we want silicon motion. I mean, maybe they, if it builds for Spark, maybe they have a conditional there that maybe we could patch that. Yeah, but what did we had there? What did I say? I said, I mean, that, not that it would matter the most, but Alpha and Spark. If you want this for more, then please send a patch of patching that for real. So this was Alpha and not really that much shorter, but at least you immediately see for what it works. Yeah, it's a little bit shorter and we would have to add NEOS too, so. And we don't need to update this for all the other crazy additional architectures like probably Blackfin and who knows what. Oh, this temp is interesting outside base. Okay, so it's good that we checked that. That did not yet work. This is oops. It's exactly the thing we wanted to patch actually. So good that we didn't commit this because it didn't work. Don't build for video silicon motion on use to convert by don't build sich motion on use to by converting possibly more whatever. Paul says there's still a few things on to do before release. Well, not really. This to do is like next year and future, so not going to fix all of this. So there's next to nothing left. The biggest thing is this temp, and then otherwise we can just wait for maybe three people. Three people agree to wait for that. But this temp, so this was based here. What do we have there? F-list valid. Junk. For non ignored. Created vanished. File outside. Import soon. F list base X base. Where do we have X base and F list? Root, what do we have about top level? Okay, this was actually not that one here. Base dear off. Where do we have that? F-list valid xbase, f-list valid of xbase less equal to x, what is xbase and f-list valid? F-list valid. Oh, wait a second, here is temp. Base temp for backups. Base and X base, we lock that already. What did we build? Mipso. MIPS little onion, like for the some MIPS embedded stuff. I think our creator CI20 there. That was Linux. So this are these two bases. Why do we not? I mean, we probably could put Nice. It probably must have like touched slash temp for some bizarre reason. Paul says need to watch that security news. Which security news video? One of ours or a third party one? Grab F-list wallet, F-list wallet is X-Base and F-list, so this is adding to that. And maybe we try that. Let's see, grab F-list wallet in. Actually quite some stuff. Actually Tempest is in there already as I expected. Interesting. F-list wallet. Yeah, temp is there. So base temp, X base, USO linked on the pulse only. Did I link a security news? Did I make a mistake or whatever? So the all okay. We also need that. Let's try what is in there. So that is correctly that. Let's add it there too. And then let's try this grep again. Ah, this outputs nothing? What? This is slightly bizarre that why do I get other output now than oh wait a second, this is doing that twice, right? We first grab that. Do we grab exactly the same thing twice? Grab, okay, this is QB. We could actually rewrite that in the same manner like the other one. Like, not that it would be that important, but no, it's not the greatest fan of doing stuff twice. Only wondering why. Oh, right, because this is Q, of course. Okay, but is that correct stuff or what do we via read file if exist file? This is. Ah, wait. Did I paste that right? This actually checks for slash here. That could actually be the thing with temp. We would, without the slash, I think this is probably why temp doesn't filter out. By the way, also, yeah, you attention to detail, right? This is the kind of stuff you need to look out for. Otherwise, you could debug more hours on the stuff until realizing, wait a second, there was a slash. Do we even need that slash there? I would kind of argue maybe not. The problem is, if we modify that, we should debug that with something. So let's take a small package like What would be like, let's take some min pages. And you know what, let's like create artificially a file hook at pre-make 5 touch root abc and mkdir root actually maybe even touch simply root tempfs for temp for maximum coverage, because it should be directory. Let's see. For building 2 min pages, and I need coffee. Also, of course, I really hate this. This is so Windows. Hate this so much. Interesting that only did ABC. Let's try that top level temp. Maybe even temp and temp 1, 2, 3. Just. Yeah, text for busy is super annoying. This is when I think Vim is opening that exclusively for preventing other editors to edit the same file or some nonsense like that. What? Why does it? And this is a new thing, or at least I previously used NVI, and NVI didn't do that, or is it the other way around? Is this still NVI? Anyway, one of NVI, it might also be NVI, a new version of NVI or something. But why did that fail now? Strange. Now this works. If you want it to fail, it doesn't fail. And if well, we could maybe touch, or the touch should. We could also. A little bit annoying. When you want stuff to fail, it doesn't fail. Oh, what annoying stuff. Has someone an idea how to reliably make this fail? We could x equals, okay, temp, and then move x to slash, let's see if that, I need to cause an error just to main page, isn't it? What's going on now? Premake, move, why does this not? Somehow this is not, or maybe because this expands too early. This is expands already now. Pro tip, I think single quotes of not expanding that at parsing time. So, but then we can finally, we have outside based here that we can finally debug that. Sometimes the biggest amount of time, certainly often debugging stuff and then also creating a test case at times, like, yeah, especially for this edge cases, like the build package. That would be top, also top level, right? Let's share file. So this is while reads the stuff here, and I copy that pattern not to make mistakes, right? I don't want to waste another 30 minutes. So pro tip, copy of what is already working to have your forward backward job. So because we want this while read loop in your foreground shell job and for setting variables like breaking there. So top level of here, so that just to optimize, not to need to run this twice. Where is here somewhere? Why do we have the twice? Does it look twice via read egrep? Nah. Welcome. Wood. So let's rewrite that. So I don't think there's any good reason why is this so. This is exactly the same, right? Isn't it? Egrep v flist valid. Right lock. Cut, except with cut, F to sort unique. Let's maybe test that first. Pro tip, test this first, that it is still equivalent. I mean, this is already the same pattern, right? This is already that. Aboard soon, so so, read this stuff, if the file access created file, outside based here. Non-fiddle for no created vanished file. ignore file. And theoretically, we could. This is a little bit maybe like that, and then ignore it behind the file or something, a little bit more. Native English speakers, leave in the comments below if you want slightly improved grammar wording and stuff. I think this is a little bit more readable. So e grab the stuff, cut sort. So yeah, I guess it could should be equivalent. Let's test that. So yeah, looks like that still works. Created file outside base tier, base one, base two. We could also check if we get this message, like totally over testing that. Let's maybe copy that also. Copy x2. Need to remove something like that to slash everything of x trailing removed with a two postfix. Let's see, just wanna massively test that we only get this header there once, and you see, created, we didn't. So much to testing top level. Oh, by the way, the other shared found dubs. Okay, this is all right, because base. Yeah, because soon. Okay, we had so much for testing. Found some, so let's put that here, and at the end, after the message, one or the other, if exist, otherwise deleted file, and then this is found duplicates, found errors, abort soon. Do we have so then found really duplicates found invalid. What was the other pattern, just to have this in sync font? Okay, this is equal zero, fair enough. No, we don't really need this. I mean, we could theoretically touch this. We could have it like zero and simply whatever. So font invalid equals zero. Not my most favorite pattern, but I don't want to change the other one now. So, good that we tested that, because even we overlook stuff, especially when we chat here live on YouTube. We're happy you enjoy this, or debugging, script testing. So, yeah, base 1, base 2, found outside base dir, and base 1, base 2, and file outside, so yeah, I guess that is. Means the only other thing we could theoretically, but it doesn't matter too much, but print that out first. But okay, fine, so that works. Now that this works, we can, what we actually wanted to do is test that that was in temp. So let's remove all this fancy the best thing would be to test that with the build really failing. So this was Linux temps. I'm still not created file outside base dir. Still not really sure how this happens. But all right, because it's grepping. I'm pretty sure it must have used something like touching this directory. I'm only not sure why it doesn't. Whatever strange stuff it's doing there. Wood Potter writes, love, we code in Vim. Yeah, I mean, if you, by the way, is this, yeah, this is not even Vim, this is NVI, right? The not as improved. I was joking, people always ask me, is this fancy and that and Wayland and just. I said so often, just give me text terminal and a freaking NVI or, yeah. It's certainly crazy. Even my, this is of course an epic thread ripping Horizon 15 or 50X and kind of sort of overkill build, but the good thing is you can work like this on data center, even on not the fastest mobile connections like off grid or sailing, touring and in your van. Besides saving resources or leaving resources for your important task like training an AI model or machine learning and stuff. And otherwise with stuff like Xcode, even yeah, Visual Studio, certainly one thing, Xcode another thing. And even with Xcode, the Retina MacBook Pro, the aging 7-year-old or so stuff of whatever that was, 11.2 or something, from 7 years ago, even that in the meantime really annoying or starting to be annoying to use in Xcode, so yeah, certainly aware of that. All right, you know what, we should have, you know what, I probably removed that already, right? Because I should have actually left it in there. Also my paper holder. Getting autumn here on this side of the world. I should have left it in there for better testing because I slightly wonder why do we have a slash on this expression? Can we do away? Actually, okay, maybe we have a slash on this to check versus like lib. If we would not have a slash there, let me so this is invalid. This slash here, otherwise, okay, this is removing that. Yeah, so I think otherwise actually we could actually test that that otherwise we would remove like lib, any lib if we, let's maybe maximum test this here. I don't want to touch this the next decade, so it's better. Oh yeah, pro tip, if you don't want to touch this for a decade or so, like not touch this code for 10, 15 years, do it mostly right and test the heck out of it before you commit it. Pre-make 5, that would be... this time not repeating that mistake again. Oh, no. Okay, temp, and then like move that to... move that to the actual this root of with everything removed. And lib, so lib, just for maximum testing, because I wanna modify that for slash without temp to just work. Or would it actually? We don't need. Oh no, we need slash. Oh, that is a little bit. That is a little bit tricky. How do we do that? Because of course the path is usually longer. I mean, this is really a strange case of stuff. I mean, the stuff must somehow with something. Actually, we should have a log of that. Yeah, if you were wondering why I didn't improve that for like a decade, like it only happens sometimes, and then it's relatively annoying. If a wrapper write log, what even did do here slash temp mkdir. Oh, this is even our own mkinitrd. Our own stuff is failing that. Wow. Wow. And maybe we should simply fix our mkinitrd not to do that. Although I'm not entirely sure how we do that. But yeah, is this not log? Be pro, like professionals for 20 years in the making, if you're wondering, right? Who has such an amazing log here in your fully automated Linux distribution? I love this log. Okay, let's commit this for now. Also, I think we might not need temp in the other. So this would be line nearly 666 build package of 6, was it 664 or 64? Yeah, 644. That comes from making 666 jokes. That was line 644. Why did I not 644? What? Ah, here. Too many directory characters in this forest. So simplified another loop. That was doing that twice for no good reason. Hey, at this pace, maybe one day we can build on a 40 megahertz Spark station again. Found invalid, I think this was tested enough, right? Simply fight invalid top level dir loop to only run once. Pretty fine. So what else do we have there? Kind of Linux kernel, just a hobby, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, just a tiny one unsuccessful hobby. No, just kidding. I said this before, right? The individual many videos you probably want to share, like and subscribe and watch some old videos, including I made some videos. Can you make money with open source? Super difficult. And long story, I'm also disappointed by the big Linux business, like Linux Foundation stuff. They pay each other millions, hundreds, thousands to millions of compensations for running around with Macs, presenting with PowerPoint, and all the individual people, not only me, but certainly 10,000 others, get nothing. And in my opinion, this should change. And even with the RISC-V, I made a popular video there, RISC-V, that was mentioned at Linus Tech Tips and Level One Tech. RISC-V stuff here, RISC-V64 and latest RDNA 2. And I even reached out, there is some kernel stuff to be done that so far only I have done as a prototype there on the previous YouTube video on the main channel. And I reached out to Sci-5, Hi-5 companies there of RISC-V stuff and AMD, multiple people, multiple ways of via LinkedIn, I got next to no response. Like, I only asked, like, hey, I put already 10 or so hours into this. This is working proof of concept. Do you not want to sponsor like a day of my work, like 8 hours or something, and like reasonable rate in the Western world, like let's say $100 an hour, certainly not much, especially for rich companies like AMD or kind of sorta highly valued startups like Hi-5, Sci-5. And next to no response, the only one who responded was Bridgman of all fame of AMD, and only because I queried him directly also with LinkedIn. Ironically, some people of Hi-5, Sci-5 confirmed my contact request, but didn't even bother to reply, right? In my opinion, really, I mean, we as a super small company, right? My little small company, so many customers say we do amazing support, outstanding responses, round trip times and stuff. And yeah, 2021, small companies often, or usually, but no surprise, right? Small companies have better support and everything than big business. And in my opinion, for very big businesses like AMD or sort of successful startups like Hi-5, Sci-5, especially those with community ambitions or kind of sort of open, I mean, not like really open, but pseudo open community ambitions. I say pseudo open because they don't even publish their whole specification for their hardware and stuff, which I would even for free write the driver for the RTC, for the real-time clock, for the unmatched Hi-5 board. But yes, I didn't find any documentation for even for the freaking lousy real-time RTC there, and it's sad. And even for that I queried them, even on the website I queried multiple times, like I think twice, for the, they have their query stuff, Hi-5 unmatched, they have their query for the whole they have their, feel like for some hardware manual somewhere was query, some stuff, I filled this twice for, hey, can you send me the freaking errata, right? And yeah, open, we are community, we are amazing, and they can't even publish the errata. Of course, everyone would agree, and that Intel and AMD and Nvidia, of course, Nvidia is not doing this, all silicon should have erratas published for those people working with it. So I don't even have the freaking errata, right? And not only that, I mean, and they have the stuff here, and then even have the arrogance, they have the arrogance of not publishing it, and twice doubling down on the arrogance of not even freaking responding to my inquiries of being a customer, of having shed out $666, nearly approximately dollar for this stuff. And here the unmatched hardware reference manual is also not published. And yeah, no response. And this is, yeah, I made a good PR of promoting RISC-V and stuff, which is of course open and not their product, but even promoted the product, and they can neither get back to me for the errata, neither publish voluntarily the hardware reference manual, nor send it to people who inquire, nor freaking respond to their inquiries on LinkedIn. And I would have, I mean, I didn't ask for $5,000 or $10,000, right? I only ask, hey, I put in already 8 or 10 hours or so as seen live on YouTube. It's not, and I only ask for like half, or realistically maybe even have a quarter of the time. Not even like, hey, I have this done, please pay me. I was like, I have this prototype and I can finish it. Would you want to sponsor this? Like a day, I think I wrote a day or two, like 8 or 16, like $1,000 to $2,000, right? And this big business cannot, for 20 years veteran open source developers, cannot get their ass up and put some marketing money. And I'm not a nobody, right? So even for relatively prominent people, they can't even freaking respond, right? Not, I would have at least appreciated, in good style, right, if on LinkedIn's like, hey, hello, amazing, thank you for your YouTube video, thank you for all your work done. Unfortunately, we have no budget. I, by the way, heard from someone here say they, although high five, sci-five, a little bit insider knowledge, maybe I should not tell that, but you think they're super successful, and I think they have 100 millions of funding, I guess. But I heard some people told me, not sure if that is true and stuff and how accurate, but despite being a successful open hardware startup thing and hyped and future and stuff, I heard they have some restructuring because it's usual open source budget and company restructuring and startup and stuff. So if you have more stuff or want to share, if you are an ex-employee, so they let some people go, I heard, and reshuffling, restructuring and whatnot. So maybe their financial situation is not as rosy. Maybe they already spent all their, certainly it's costly to develop all the hardware and software. But my request, and my request would have made the RISC-V Linux kernel better in general and supported AMD RDNA 2 on RISC-V. It would have been a win-win. It would have made the Linux kernel better in two ways, of adding new features needed for RDNA 2 AMD GPU and enabling RDNA with that. Not only making the Linux kernel better with that features needed, but additionally enable RDNA 2. It's like, yeah, but $1,000 to $2,000 too much for. So yeah, if you want to make a living, don't do open source recurring theme here. And I ironically said a couple of times, I should actually not put so much work into D2, because only with your Patreon, yeah, Patreon, GoFundMe, right, if you want to support this stuff more than AMD and High Five, then you know where the sponsoring links are. And yeah, no, we digressed a little bit due to that, as always. Yeah, and nowadays I would not, in 2021, I would not start this from scratch. I only continue this because I, for 20 years, put too much effort in there, and despite not making that much money with it, because all my embedded customers for 20 years told me, this stuff needs to just work. Why should we pay you to, we would pay you to create something for our product, but the base stuff needs to just work, as you see, everything just freaking works here. I'm totally no effort necessary to make this work. And it's like, yeah, my customers, my potential, kind of, sort of. Yeah, it's hilarious, it's sad. What do we have there? Missing operand, okay, we did say something wrong. So yeah, I only continued that because I put too much effort into that, and it's, in my opinion, one of the best Linux build systems out there, which is certainly why I would want to use that. All right, we have here that, so that should be X to there. Let's see if that works. And also only with this YouTube channel, right? If there would not be this YouTube channel I try to grow, and having the perfect Linux for myself, I would not start this from scratch. So we have libtemp, so that is exactly what we wanted to test, because I think if we, just to check that, valid, what do we have, valid, what was it, base one, or space, here was it somewhere. I think if we remove that, so then we do not grab, so that would remove, because we have lib in there, that would remove that. We could basically, we could, what did we even build? Did we build that? I lost overview. Oh, here did we build this? No, of course. Let's see if, hope we don't. Yeah, of course we get this. This is really annoying. Maybe I should actually use Vim. I think Vim might not have this stupid issue. Let's see what comments do we have there. What did let's so this it reminds me of times homeless guys asked to develop web app could get a budget, but what's it reminds me of the time this homeless guy was asked to develop a web app. They could get a budget, but they were not to pay the guy. What? So, what do we have? So, okay, we have this. This is. Did I not just remove this here? Interesting that this still. Let's test that again. Let's debug that a little bit because I want that this is more rock solid. I don't want to, as I said, I don't want to touch this the next decade. So that would be XBase and flist-wallet. And then grepping. Oh, by the way, is this a tab or? Oh no, yeah, it is a tab. Oh, this is why this may not work. This is maybe why it was previously yielding other results. Do we copy and paste this with others? The problem is it's not even that easy to type a tab there. I wonder, can't we do that like that? I always prefer that over not invisible. Pro tip. Escape stuff because invisible stuff is annoying. That probably is a. Oh, here. That probably is a tab there. Yeah. It's basically second field, but. What do we. Here, it's somewhat annoying to type a tab. How would you? Yeah, sometimes these details are annoying. It's more difficult and annoying than it should be. That clearly doesn't work like this. I mean, I could. Wait a second, tip something, something. What do we have? The source? Did even color. But the sum was always annoying. What does? We could use SAD though. I mean, we could or otherwise. Actually, we could add that to a file and source it. Okay, that works better. Mkdir, that is what we wanted. So that actually works. So how does var temp, why is, wait a second, why is this, now we have vi in the mix. Oh, that is interesting, that is even var temp. It's a little bit unexpected that we always something else. What did we build? Man pages, why is this now? We should have this other. Temp deer in there. Why do we not have? Lib temp in there. What lib temp? that lib temp we should have in there, why do we not have? What have I done now? Oh, darn, we need to. So maybe this indeed behaves as I wanted. Maybe I've tested that wrong. No? Why is this? I'm confused. Grab V. Okay, actually we don't have, oh wait a second, this is top level directory, we don't, all right, we anyway would need, do we need to slash? What a mess. Actually, we don't have lib in there, flist valid, we have the only this kind of stuff, and we should not have variations of that. All right, but then it's removing. Okay, if we. But we could explicitly, we could basic, but that. What we theoretically would want besides this whole stuff is a little bit of a mess. You know what? Let's maybe just fix our MK initRD not to create this temp there. Because otherwise, theoretically, we would need to match either ending or slash, and that is a little bit. I think you can't do that easily with regular expressions, previous video. Where you would probably need to have them all twice, once terminating with end. So. Would ask OCR engine mostly by or create by us. Well, we found some best pieces and improved on them, and but it's not based on any of the other big open source ones, because like Tesseract is like 10 times slower and stuff. Yeah, let's leave it like this. I think this is too fragile to right now improve differently. What did I want? Okay, so let's remove that stuff here already, and let's see, so that stuff, revert the two. And so here we probably want to show that. And how long do we have? One. It's not actually, we streamed other stuff. When our OBS crashed, how long do we live stream already? Need to probably reload that here too. What, stream is not available? Why? Something went wrong. What? All right, because I changed the. Probably changed the YouTube channel here. And then let's rather change our MK initRD. That should. It's of course ironic that our own code is. Creating it like that. does it say now? Cannot connect to live stream. Always something. 2 hours. Oh, thanks for that. Yeah, somehow can't connect. Whatever it's wrong with my Firefox video now. So mkdir, what do we do there? Mkdir. So this is a temp dir. We mkdir temp dir with. So this temp dir is also what we do here with mk temp dir somewhere. Temp dir there. Temp dir map. Where do we even? Map is mk temp dir. That is why. And so temp dir, maybe we have a typo somewhere of slash temp, temp dir. Maybe we only, here's dir name. Maybe we have, if not skip dir name, temp dir extension. Mk dir cover, temp dir etc. Temp dir. Sometimes let's just fix our own code is easier said than done. If change mod init, so that is all prefixed. So that is cd there. As I expected, don't see. Do we have, also we don't have directly. Maybe so mkdirp does do that. Here's some dir, is that temp dir dir is temp dir removal of maybe we should run this with. So this is in Mipso? Was it Mipso? Let's see, build Mipso. So that would be spin mkinit rd. This directory, do we run this like this or with this? And then let's maybe pass that through s trace. Paul asks, why do I prefer NVI? Actually, this comes mostly from the earlier days of Rock Linux, when nowadays we can cross-compile probably 50% plus or minus, which is amazing, because then we compile for Neos or Spark and so on an epic thread-ripping AMD Ryzen. And 20 years ago, when mostly I started, because I supported PowerPC at Rock Linux and then Spark and then MIPS and actually ARM early and then everything else. And then cross-compiling NVI was among the, back in that day we only could cross-compile the bootstrap stuff, and NVI was one of those things that cross-compile, and I never like needed more. It's like I don't really need syntax highlighting to code and stuff, so NVI was enough. And this way smaller one, right? So code base is like a magnitude smaller. Although nowadays, the slightly ironically, after 15 years, I updated that recently. We didn't update NVI for like 15 years. And recently, with the effort here of always, this thing is there, like checking each and every thing that there could be an update, I found someone updated NVI or added there some new stuff and so on. And so I updated this. So some of these annoyances are only because the newer NVI of some people continue to work on that with even BDB for the undo database and stuff. So ironically, the new version is for me not more annoying. And nowadays we can also cross-compile Vim. Also, the new version of Vim also has like, it's, I have different issues with that. For example, if I run the newer version of Vim, so newer of the last years, I get, also files created in slash dev, like, or used in dev pts and stuff, so probably sorry, need to patch some stuff also in Vim to work better, because it's doing too much stuff also, not the same, but similar and annoying, of locking and whatnot. So minimal probably should be enough. Let's run this with, I'm pretty sure this, ironically, right, just the other day, updated Alacrity and now this has this. I'm pretty sure I never had this for months. So this, it must, yeah, writing this on Rust and memory safety and stuff. Not only, it's the terminal that crashed the most on me. Why do I even use this? I'm probably Wayland native, I guess. I hope. It's like, yeah, 2021 written in Rust for safety and stuff. And then the one that crashes more than Xterm and RxVT Unicode. And now has off by one bug, apparently, with the last character of what's. Okay, is that not amazing? Yeah, amazing state of software and stuff. Terminals. We didn't have too many terminals. We had to write more in Rust that crash and have off by one error issues. 090, yeah, that's not. Actually, this release is actually quite some days old. Certainly quite some 8 days ago. Oops, better this one. Let's look. Might even fix cursor inversion, address configuration, type on my file indicator. Yeah, what cursor? Nah, whatever. So, we want a temp. Actually, it does indeed mkdir. It does that often. Why? Why does it do so much mkdir here? It's not even once, it's constantly changed here. Why is it doing that? That is bizarre. What is Vim Tiny? Is it a build configuration of? In T2 we built, is it a Debian or so thing of also shipping that twice with different feature sets? We do that a little bit similar, previous video. Vim is so huge code base and stuff that on an SGOctane it took, or Spark Station, on some of those 300 megahertz things from high-end machines from decades ago, it took quite a while to load 100 megabytes of shared objects. We also built this twice. So what I usually run with Vim is a reduced, not org edition, for improved performance, especially on vintage machines. So here's something. This is rather, I mean, we kinda, I mean, this must be from our stuff or change dir. Oh, wait a second, this is probably, this is with P, this is probably, this must be the PR, here's mkdir temp. Actually, I think it's a, maybe this is a strange behavior of mkdir. Actually, maybe this is not, because it's just the whole path of, it's probably mkdir slash P. No error, it's like, maybe we, which one would that be? Also, we have quite some, this is actually quite, also quite annoying. So yeah, one work running that one way is annoying, working around another way is also annoying. Okay. Dear, maybe this would be like this. Actually, what we could do, I mean, this temp dear, it temp dear, we temp dear. Mm. thing is, I mean, if we change our directory in there, if we, okay, temp, actually, this is, can we rely on temp dir? I mean, what a mess now, just to avoid that. What is dir? It has a whole temp dir in there. Fn dir of fn. Sorry if it's tired of Windows being full stack one stuff, but those books, broad range, last video. It's actually also a little bit fragile here. Do we change dir CD somewhere? Only there. Actually, the irony is here we change dir already. So basically, if we change to temp, actually we could change to that temp dir, so that would be temp dir minus. Oh yeah, what a hackery, just to avoid massive amounts of mkdp there. So that would be change to that without temp dir without one trailing slash, maybe set x just for the, so cd there, and then mkdir just the last one. I mean, what a trickery, just to avoid this. I wonder that. Also, yeah, usually we don't see that, because not that much other stuff is MK during stuff in temp as much, probably. So temp dir, then remove everything but the directory. So we removed only one, so that should be mostly safe, probably MK dir. All that stuff, and then CD temp dir. Let's see what happens. Ah, what a mess. So cd temp, okay, this didn't quite work. Actually, wait a second, this is interesting. Does that, actually, that is not really what I wanted, but does that mkd as a parent or not? No, it says existing file, thank you very much. Yeah, it just does mkd that without, okay. What a trickery just for that. So temp dir, this didn't work yet. What have we done there? That was a remove one. This was cd mk dir. What have I? Ah, bloody text file is busy. Oh man. who invented that should, it's, you had one job, it's hilarious. I already hate this on Windows, Lily only knows this from Windows. What have we done there too? So mkdir, so cd, this is the mkdir line, mkdir is tempdir and remove, wait a second. This is why. And so mkdir that, cdz that, and then basically do not change directory anymore and mkdir p probably here is okay. Because we are in this directory now, we don't need that anymore. And okay, dear, given that we should, so it's of course really error prone now and fragile and error prone, not the greatest fan. I mean, theoretically, this should not error out, but yeah. How do we do that best? That is mod info. Does it need firmware? So that is from the whole path here, and then adding tempdir. Actually, given that we are in this directory, we probably don't need to prefix that here. I would say tempdir. We only actually this is relative. We should, because this is absolute path or relative path to where we are, that probably should be fine, right? Mkdir p, and then skipped, if not skipped, then tempdir xt, that xt, what is xt? Xt skips the root prefix of that, so I guess why do I run dir name on that? Theoretically could done this in shell though. Why did I not do that in shell? Output each name with last non slash component. Trailing slashes removed if name contains no means. I don't quite know why I did that with dir name. So what else do we have? Was it all dir name dots? What do we have here? Dir name. Wait a second, we have here more. Dear name, dear. So that was that. That was dear name, that. That was okay here. So that generate map file. MK dear lib. So we should not have moved. So lib modules. Mod dear modules to. Lib modules. Oops. What do we have there? Edit. Okay. Tempdir of. This is libdir in all of those. Mkdir. So we should not have moved. So instead of tempdir current directory. Mkdir y. Should we test that? Famous last words. Time something something, no such trajectory. Oops. So much to cannot create regular file. Nah, that didn't went well. Hey, Jamerican. Welcome everyone tuning in to our Linux community channel here. How many people are we? Okay, 10.10 patches were not included. Do we not or no? These have different PC IDs. Yeah, not having a 5000. Yeah, given I ordered a MacBook coming soon to this on the main channel. Hope that arrives next week. I was waiting all year for a Lenovo X13, but as I need a MacBook anyway for Mac development and testing and stuff, and the performance and energy efficiency is certainly great. And people on the previous polls asked for Apple Silicon Linux anyway, so yeah, that is coming here. So what have we there? Mkdir creating what? Why do we have that here? So why do we have that? I have no Mkdir. Why do we have rm-rf? That is somehow bizarre. Oh, what crit? Why do we wipe that first? Why have I done that? Why? Mkdir, tempdir. By the way, oh wait, we made a mistake anyway, which is actually changing into there or not. Oh, that looks better. But yeah, if you have patches, accumulating those patches, I mean, I certainly should focus on building the YouTube channel way faster with more mainstream content, although people might hate this, but this also would allow me to, is it here even, with the S-Pen disk type. The larger the channel, the faster and larger the channel grows, the more money I can spend on stuff and present stuff to the community, like MacBook review and so on. If money is no objection, of course can buy a Lenovo X13 additionally. Lenovo X13, you see I googled this already multiple times. But I just checked last week and it was still not shipping in Germany. This is DE. Yeah, the whole year soon, like yeah, soon, since Easter, since April or May or whenever, soon, it's like, yeah, thank you very much. Also in America, in the US, you can get, yeah, probably short supply, totally understand that, but Lenovo then also needs to understand that after 6 months, I need a laptop or, you know, need, yeah, starting at, so this is, yeah, in the US, you get that now. This is really sad though. Wow, you get this with 45% freaking off already or what? Are you effing kidding me? Why don't you sell those for the full price to us in the European Union? You had, yeah, wow. What does, black is a color, okay. Wow, is that crazy? ThinkPad holidays of 40 only live on this channel. That's, man, this is so sad. Maybe I should ship this to a friend in the US and have that. The only problem is then with the bloody orange Trump president exposed import custom tax now, much more stricter than before. Even if I send this to a friend now, I have the, you can get an amazing display now. Wow. Because the last time I checked, you could only get the bloody full HD. So this is, of course, Yeah, I mean, with this, I mean, yes, Lenovo, give it to me. Shut up and take my money, man. Yeah, but the Mac, although, I mean, this price is of course amazing, right? I mean, a similar, I mean, honestly, well, with the full, yeah, I mean, the full price is, yeah, oh, you don't see this fully. With this 45 freaking percent, man, is it 45%? This is so hilarious that they don't ship this to the EU right now. I mean, do they have Lenovo FR X13 Gen 2 AMD? Can I order this in France? You never know. No, it's possible. Merci beaucoup, Lenovo. Not getting my money. My money's. Yeah, so yeah, there you have it. Happy US folk there, you can. But so with the full price, that is of course expensive, but you also see how much profit margin they have. Right? This is of course crazy that they out of nowhere they can give you. Was it 45% or. Yeah, 45 freaking. Man, I would have. Yeah, but big companies, right? I mean, they rather sell. Instead of making more money selling it to like people who desperately want that in the rest of the world, like in the EU, they give US customers 45% off. And also, yeah, even with this supply shortages, right? With this, what would that be performance-wise, though? That is 8 cores. Is this competitive with M1 Max. Probably not though. Let's take something. Yeah, I think the MacBook Pro scores are higher. Although, yeah, they have. Yeah, the cores are, yeah, this is crazy, right? How advanced, I mean, yeah, I said this oftentimes, right? PA semi power efficient silicon. Like, yeah, you get way more, so that would be, where do we have that? 18, I'm not sure which of those is now. Which of those is the. Or 14 inch. But yeah, you get so much more L1 cache, double the. Oh, wait a second, you get way more. Wow, if this is correct, not sure, but you get more data cache than. Oh, no, they have. So you get what? 4 times the instruction cache, 2 times the L1 data cache, and 8 times the L1 cache, apparently, maybe, although you have whopping. A 3 cache here that you don't have there, but anyway, performance-wise, I mean, this graph's a little bit annoying. Some of the graphs are strangely formatted. Maybe a bug. I think they previously looked different. So yeah, faster IPC. Yeah, how advanced is this Apple? Also, yeah, previous videos right, RISC-CISC and like yeah, complex instructions architecture. And people on Twitter told me, yeah, YOLO, RISC-CISC is long gone nowadays. x86 is internally RISC anyway. It's like yeah, but. Freaking complex variable length instruction decoder. Yeah, sure. I spend significantly more for the Apple machine, which I need anyway. Especially, well, I don't get it for the full price. Not even the, not to speak about the discount. But with the discount, if you, yeah, also vote with your. I said so often, vote with your money and buy stuff that you. Like more repairable, more mod. Although yes, it's sold out anyway. So yeah. Although to be fair, I would need to add 1 terabyte there. Oh, why do we? Yeah. Yeah. If you specs are similar, then you nearly approach Apple levels. And that's not yet the display. Although the Apple display is way better though. Yeah. List price you reach similar, but yeah, this discount is crazy. lucky Americans. So, what is with this? We probably want to test this now. Do we need to probably test that init already is created correctly? Should that be safe? Yeah, whatever. Famous last words. Let's first see if there. So what else do we have there? I should probably just publish the Discord stuff here more publicly. That is, of course, I should publish that probably on the T2. Publish that order. Wait, why is this again? Expire never. Somehow today it's different link than usual. US mail forward address. Yeah, I guess. I mean, first of all, I probably can't configure that with a German keyboard, right? I mean, with typing, if I for longer than a test type like 4 years on a US keyboard, I get crazy. Yeah, only 4 options. Yeah, so don't get a freaking German keyboard though, which is, yeah, you can do without, but it's annoying in the long term. And plus Texas and stuff. ESD, so okay, fine, whatever. But yeah. So let's extract that. We probably should have, for best test coverage, should have created a before and after snapshot. But let's see what we got. So that is set standard decompress the init rd. This is so annoying. Yeah, alacrity, thank you very much. You had one job in set standard d. CPIO I. Yeah. And what did we got there? Is it all complete? Or at first glance, it looks quite complete. We have devs, we have bins, we have libs. We probably could be fine. Again, ideally, what I usually do, and just with all the stuff and rushing it. So on. Usually I create a before and after and did that, and then you have. What else do we have there? Angelo, probably good idea to just ship it. Firefox will pull another rabbit hole to debug once it comes. Well, depends. It just builds. And I heard they enable GPU rendering for Linux or so. But certainly. I think I wait now anyway, because on the last hour of October we can just, let's, by the way, you can still vote, right? If you want to vote, YouTube, so I don't have coffee anymore. 9 votes, no, I'm on this wrong, what do we have for 100%? Yeah. So, yeah, you can still vote if you want. There. But I think we wait just few updates now, because why not? It's then the major release. Lib64, Linux there. And also we can already back up, this was it mipsil of, because we added this in package, so that would be okay, init rd there. Of course there might still be a bug in this, so we'll only find out a little bit later. Maybe the runtime improves some milliseconds with less system calls for creating the leading directories there, the leading parent directories. Completely not sure why I'd done that here though, whatever it was. Anyway, doesn't matter at all anyway. What else do we have here? So yeah, stuff is building. Do we still have this Geekbench stuff or did I close that? Maybe we have that here. So that was Ryzen 7 Pro. Yeah, this, well, also, yeah, the memory bandwidth of the Mac is way higher. Wait a second, why does it say 64 gigs of memory? It's a tiny unfair comparison, but whatever. But yeah, the point is, the Mac is faster with everything, which... Also, I think they changed this. I did say not previously had a bar graph here of plus minus. That is a little bit strange. Not a fan of... Pretty sure that was different. Did I post my links twice? Paul says, in case it already exists, it should not be tempted that with some random directory, so it shouldn't. So whatever I've done there. Maybe from prototyping in some directory, maybe. Maybe it's left over from prototyping. Hey, there's one benchmark where image compression, where... Oh, two AES. Two specific things, that's, yeah. Anyway. Do we have a comparable 32 megabyte? I only ordered 32 megabyte. So 32 gigabyte, 32 megabyte. This is, by the way, funny. It's probably shared memory subtracted there. So here's, by the way, 18.4, 18. What is the difference here, though? Maybe one is... Here we have 32. Maybe one is certainly 16 versus 14 inch. But this looks pretty similar, all benchmark except this one, Gaussian blue. I mean, yeah, to be fair, although is this, not sure what this is benchmarking, so. Is this HTML5, is that WebKit included in Geekbench? Yeah, whatever. Yeah, the question is what platform specific stuff is running there. But even 50% faster here or so is, I mean, sometimes it's like ray tracing twice as performant. Yeah, crazy. I mean, yeah, not only do I need this for my Mac products, the temp dir is our variable. It's already the whole MK temp dir of set to the whole random directory there. Yeah, so I mean, if you want more open systems, I would recommend the Lenovo ThinkPad. Anyway, I was longing for it for 6 months already. And I mostly get the MacBook because we have those Mac products our customers already crying for better M1 support. And also additionally, people voted here, not that this would be so much of a factor, but certainly totally aware that this is a totally mainstream and what people want to see. I had this live stream with the DDK where we compiled T2 on macOS, which we probably should also improve further. And that was quite watched. So it's like, yeah, you have Linux distribution and people watch obviously more the mainstream stuff of macOS and certainly ARM, so high performance ARCH. And yeah, it will make T2 even better, ARCH 64. And the MacBook is more expensive, but you get more performance, you get a better display. I like the black chassis there of the ThinkPad, so no, this passed for the first time, so hopefully that would work. I would hope, we deleted it already. No log to test, so, but yeah, I mean, the display is certainly amazing. I slightly wonder if I work on a full screen black terminal, how much energy this would save with those local dimming zones there with, how much is it? Is it 10,000 micro LEDs? If like half of them are off, maybe improved runtime with black dark mode color themes similar to OLED, sorry. So maybe we commit that init rg, the earlier we get more test coverage, so BTG reworked mk init rd to not mk drp to avoid hard to improve top level temp, hard to improve void random, and hard to improve top level temp. Yeah. Error worked. Can you return not? Maybe we should actually diff that further. So CD there, MKD or that, CD there. Is that, by the way, yeah, temp here, so that is with the D. And temp here slash. It's always, I mean, the chance that I. Even a 50-50 chance of spotting some last minute typo, 50-50 chance of spotting typo, still better than nothing. So always pro tip, review, double and triple review stuff before you commit. That probably, except maybe Vim. For Vim we have a similar thing, but maybe we can improve that similarly. So yeah, this should probably have fixed nearly everything. Famous last words. Or ADM log, whatever we have there. Yeah, main pages. So we have not rebuilt all of that. That should. That should. What have we there? Our silicon motion in. Okay, we. This also we covered. So yeah, I think this. This should cover everything. The crazy thing is this Ryzen 1550X builds this like overnight, like maybe in 12 hours, nearly. Maybe add a little bit more because the breaks, the builds error out. But if we have this fully reproducible without spurious random temp errors and so on now, we could nearly build this every week or every major thing. I just said this a couple of times already. The only thing what is stopping me is all the excessive ISO. So all of this would be like 10 gigabyte of stuff on the download server. So it's a little bit excessive. The only benefit from that would be to catch build errors, like you update bin utils, LVM, Rust, and all this fun stuff. And if we release ISOs every quarter, which is certainly otherwise already quite some effort, we might find us at times always at a situation where stuff doesn't build then, and the big benefit except the massive like SES builds, what was the, oh that is fun, SES, oh no, this was the assembly stuff, all right, yeah, anyway, by the way, what did we build for? We had this also for X32. That main pages, okay. Yeah. Again, the big benefit of weekly builds. I mean, I could build it weekly and not publish the ISOs just to have test coverage of what is broken in that week. What got and was broken upstream in that week. Yeah, but maybe it's not worth the waste of electricity and burning those electrons just for test coverage. Maybe it is enough here. Yeah, whatever. We will see. Anyway, what do we have there? Glue? What is going on there? Platform not supported of NEOS 2? What? Auto make parse config of maybe also or NEOS 2? Quirking? No? No. Is it NEOS 2 or not? It's NEOS 2. Why does this? Should this not? Should this not usually be? I think this should be this kind of. They recognize I-860 but not NEOS 2. Is this not config? Config guest config subsession. This should kinda. Or is, I mean, there is a chance NEOS 2. Okay, we have this, the quotes don't matter here, but. There is a chance that this is already not in our systems. One glue. Updated config guess though. How is it running this config? Config guess arch target. Too many arguments? Nah. NEOS 2. What was the error? Was it config guess or config? And config guess on config. Does it not have config? Where is config sub? No. So as we updated this, that would be the right thing in theory, except apparently. Yeah, so we don't have that, so. Just patch there. I mean, it's sorted so MN NEOS 2 like something like. Oh, it's completely stupid stuff, right? I mean, MN, look at this stuff of completely no information whatsoever. Machine, it's like, yeah, thank you very much. As if that would be of any value whatsoever. Yeah, thank you very much. So we for that we need to, where is it, config, guess we need to patch automake or auto conf. We copy that from search recursively for, we copy that from share automake. And where do they have it here? Lib. Then let's patch auto. Yeah, also yeah, NIOS 2, right? Why would this be in automake? Everything just builds TM only in T2 Linux. Wait a second, do I have config? Guess vanilla also that. Move that to automake. We probably have other patches there already. Like hotfix NIOS 2 patch. Then one or two automake. ThinkPatchy look is shipping in 4+ months. Ah, thanks, I didn't. But at least in the US, it's shipping in 4+ months. In the old world, you can't even freaking order it for reservation in 4 months. What this still fails? Let's try just with that, just to make sure it's compared, it's copied. Let's try that again. Hoping for the best. No, oh come on. Why is this still not in there? Do we lock this updating that automake? It's copying, oh, it's copying that from toolchain, but I would have thought we edit that there, no? Bizarre, automake, patch that in though. Why is this not in? Ah, I know why I had this. I had this already. This is super stupid. I think this is basically copying. I had this bizarre thing. This is a little bit bug of fixing. Maybe the easiest thing would be if not package. Oh, wait a second. Automate quick or. I think the easiest thing would be has flag or then and additionally package name, because this we are fixing, like we are copying back our files. This only happens if you rebuild stuff already rebuilt, but certainly we should fix that of package, not automake it itself, then at that. Maybe and auto make, don't update our own file on, like, or don't date our own file on a rebuild or something, package, so we probably should. I only remember this, I debugged around 10 minutes on that with Black Microblaze or Blackfin or something recently, so otherwise it would probably taken me 10 minutes to debug that or something. And actually I should have patched that, so I know that works. So You see, attention to details is a small thing that only after like a decade or two fixed automatic works to not down. Oh, wait a second, we also need. Alright, it's fine. Down date our patched configs on a rebuild. And. Yeah, also new us down. Wanted to commit this in two things, but okay, fine. Now it's committed. That's what it is. We have here some more modifications. Clang and LVM. What is there with Arc? And Mesa is. I think this didn't work. Everything just builds, just not yet. Let's see what happens there. Yeah, the state increasingly just building TM. And even the most bizarre things we, in the meantime, hey, Wim. Yeah, so, of course, famous last words. It could be that this is last minute small quirks that were overdone for 15 years that break some stuff, like stuff like rebuilding everything and no files in the FLS because we messed up the grab of file stuff. But we will see. I will probably rebuild everything next week. What's going on there? Bin utils of what is there now? This was microblaze, right? What do we have there now? Install of this is stupid. Can't make this stuff up. I think I famous last quick thing. No? Maybe it's went up. Yeah, that I removed here some parallel build thing, famous quick change, and sure enough, maybe we actually need that. Toolchain. So much to that, remove your parallel install thing to save a second, and all you get is random build errors. Cheers. Fingers crossed that fixes that. Yeah, then 2022 can come, hopefully some real Threadripper, because obviously we want to cut down the build time even more. And also sooner than later implement parallel whole package builds in build target and emerge. Okay, that didn't fix that, unfortunately. Yeah, need to investigate that. Yeah, this is hilarious that the GNU people should know how to write makefile rules for their precious GNU make, and yet the GNU infrastructure stuff. So one's erroring out with random install stuff because let's continue the rest. If this is the only thing failing, I'll eventually debug that. That microblaze, what is that? That might be not having X11. And probably I should config quirk that a little bit more of. Is it none and not to binary? So probably I should change the config stuff to auto select whether X11 is built and default to not building to binaries and a UI, because obviously, yeah, that. I see. What are this Neos 2? I think this is we had that. I debugged around probably 30 minutes on this. Annoying. Yeah, everything just builds except if it doesn't. I'm pretty sure that was something like that sort. Or I think this was this not configuring. I debugged, I remember I debugged this, wasted 30 minutes on this run stuff here. I think this bind fails to build, because of course it has bundled bind. And error wall, yeah, right here. Did I not set counter? Did we not? We somehow patched that zone. Should this be patched? Is it not that one here? Why does it not apply? What are we building? Aneos 2? Is it libc? Which lib? Was this is glibc? What? Copy that to Neos 2. Oh, prompt maxes up. This is hilarious. Yeah, and why I would want to write a whole micro kernel system stuff completely from scratch, small and beautiful, and with 1% of the code of all this massive GNU Linux stuff, because trusted compute base. And yeah. Anyway, probably 3 hours, because just a tiny little bit Sunday hobby Linux maintenance stuff. Jamerican asks, when I get error 1, error 2. I look, this error doesn't tell you anything. You need to look, this is already gone. You need to look what is a real error. So I go to the end of the log file and reverse search with question mark to the first error, like usually GCC error is error colon. And if this is not a GCC error, so sometimes a GCC error, you will not necessarily get error columns. And then you need to, if that doesn't find something, you need to scroll a little bit creatively. So even sometimes, I mean, sometimes the errors are so annoying, like with complex stuff like Firefox or Rust, that you sometimes even I don't find the error in 10 minutes, which is also, yeah, if you're wondering why I'm a little bit critical thinking of build systems and modern state of hipster build systems and languages and stuff, this is exactly why, because trying for 10 minutes to find a build error. And otherwise, if error doesn't find something here, reverse searching for error colon stuff, then like stop. So you go there, it, for example, it doesn't need to be GCC. It could also be like moving a file or using some any kind of general, sometimes stuff uses Perl or Python or Ruby or PHP or God forbid Perl or stuff like, or even worse, building a binary that you then can't run with cross builds. But yeah, sometimes stuff builds a binary, like native stuff to generate something like from headers, from defines, from some tables, and it could also fail, like not GCC, but this binary, especially in cross builds, obviously, because you can't run the cross build binary except through QEMU. So yeah, go like then it's often stops and it's like generic stop stuff and whatever is then the command. Of course, embarrassingly, concurrently, parallel running that with J32 makes it more difficult, because then the log of whatever was run might not be there where the stop is if other threads and processes have run. And last but not least, the modern illness of hiding the build output by default in non-verbose builds, you might also not necessarily directly see what failed, unless make might be so nice to print the failed command, but otherwise this non-verbose builds, you know, might also not see what failed. But yeah, certainly some years of experience help with quickly navigating to what failed. What is that? DHCP for microblaze? Did I not touch over that? Or what was that micro? Microblaze? Wait a second, microblaze. This is microblaze. Oh, microblaze. Speaking of errors, this is the same thing. Did we not auto make of parse config of? No, we have microblaze there. Actually, I would argue is whatever. So we have microblaze there. Not really sure why. Must be the same thing, unless let's not guess. Let's hard facts. Microblaze, same thing. Let's not guess around. Let's config where do we have that? Oh, here, config guess apparently. Microblaze. We have some why is here exit? Or is exit where what? Why is here? Does it make sense? Exit and in case. Why was it there? Okay, maybe it was there for a reason. Okay, let's redo that. Also, I realize complexity of logs cause multi-thread. Yeah. But usually stuff shouldn't fail, and certainly 99% of the time, massive, embarrassingly parallel builds certainly more important than readable logs. So what is, or do we have said, oh wait a second, in maybe this patched wrong, because we have here case in I think some of this patched wrong. I think that probably should be like that somehow. Something of that sort. Why 943? What do we have there? Sec of case. Oh, yeah, thank you much. That's still not microblaze, so. We patch that in here, though, so. Above arm without any such. Let's check the log file of automate. Maybe this patches with some. Yeah, this patch. I know it's had to min microblaze. Yeah, but this hotfix also patches with fuzz of 2. So I guess it patches. A little bit off. We could reduce the context from. Did I? Apparently, I did this already. It's probably not helping. See if we have luck, but I guess not. No, of course not. Yeah, recurring theme. This is now even more strangely. Yes, yeah, so this is obviously patching with some patching wrong. Was that? How was it even original? It doesn't matter. We can edit this away. So that would be arm. Arm is here. Arc. Do we patch arc? Is it now due to our? Did we edit arc? No, not sure. Whatever. So. Let's rediff that. Although, maybe better patch that at M. Maybe with R. Maybe arm is more often touched. Is it alphabetically? Maybe. Let's edit here. Maybe this is less often touched and doesn't break as often. This excessive stuff I just handed it away, right? Recurring theme. Oh, what did I do here? Somehow. Oh, basically. No. And so, yeah, this we just edited away, this random stuff there. And then this was automate lib. Was it lib? We can simply check that, hotfix that. So yeah, that was lib. Let's copy that. Previous file. Oops. Pro tip, hand edit patches better than Tetris and Sudoku, and it's even free. Automate, let's try that again. Yeah, but otherwise, stuff is building, office is warming, liquid temperature 30, no, not 30, only 29 degrees. Yeah, but I guess we can next work on a MacBook review, on AAA videos, on homage to the SJ02, and all the other cute, more mainstream stuff I have here on my to-do list, for which you want to share, like, and subscribe also to the more main channel there on there. And yeah, if you like all this in-depth, low-level, and massive parallel open-source building stuff for all the architectures that few people use, and there is also Patreon, GoFundMe, GitHub sponsors, and YouTube membership, if not OnlyFans for you. I guess we can commit automake, hotfixed the MicroBlaze hotfix. You can never patch that stuff. Also, I wonder why this is not upstream, right? Maybe I should actually freaking send it upstream, collect some easy to collect. What's it called? Collect some easy collectible fame for all of that. Maybe I should. That would not cost so much time for all this stuff, but anyway. So yeah, there we have it. Did other stuff, by the way, build like RISC-V, and where are we there? Okay, man pages, that is an easy thing. Now Linux, what is that? That is, which architecture was that? Neos 2, oh, thank you very much. Build Neos 2 for, of course. Why should Linus Torvalds stuff build here? This might be OS optimization, or VM, VMSF, We could see if that goes away with optimizing for speed or so, and not OS. Sometimes that helps with this GCC built-in. So RISC-V 64. Maybe we should actually package Doom 3 and build it for RISC-V and play that here. Man pages, yeah, that was everything. Yep, so yeah, so long live stream, even the coffee machine, even the coffee maker already suspends energy saves, and I guess that's it's actually theoretically, yeah, I guess that's mostly it for this video, except I think we had some patches here. And welcome there. I think we had some patches like that one or other packages. What is that? Is that new or somewhere we had some? Maybe I should apply them. Cache and desk, CGC client, missing Perl, something missing socket, something like that. Maybe, by the way, recent stuff, SIP is, SIP is always, yeah, maybe recent stuff. So, otherwise, stuff is building, stuff looks good, I guess we shouldn't break too much next week, and then when Firefox and Linux are out, ship it, quickly rebuild overnight, and ship it. That's finally it for today, probably 3 hours in, because why not? Yeah, 3 hours, did you say? I said 3 hours when I meant 4. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon for all the more fun stuff to come.